Well, it's an important announcement because it shows that the transition process is on track. We had the first phase of transition provinces which went into transition last July. This is the second phase. We will see different districts of Helmand come into the process. It shows that the overall strategy of transferring security responsibility to the Afghans by the end of 2014 is proceeding very well, because I think after this announcement, 50% of the Afghan population will be in areas, provinces or districts where the Afghan security forces are in the lead. I've been able to track the progress, and Nadi Ali was a pretty kinetic area when I arrived. Now the Afghans are going about their daily business, getting their goods to market, roads have been built, schools have opened, clinics are open. I mean, it's not incident free, nowhere is, but the place is ripe for the Afghan police and the Afghan army to take on their responsibility.
How long has it been like this?
Three or four days.
Yeah. And what's all this? What's that? Dried blood?
Piaz.
It's an onion.
Onion?
Onion, yeah.
Okay, Roger. Why have you put an onion on?
I think there's been a process of building and developing the Afghan National Security Forces over the past few years. NATO ISAF troops have been securing and holding areas, driving out the Taliban, creating the conditions and basically buying time for the Afghans to take on their own responsibility. It's a strong point of agreement between the coalition forces and the Afghan government that we want to transfer this responsibility, and this announcement is an important sign of progress on that score.
I've come down here for 2 points, first of all. First point, to see how you are, see if the patrol in the area is still quiet whilst since ISAF have been away. And the second point is to finalise the transfer of PB Chile, this place, from ISAF into the Northern Cape lands of yourselves, the ANCOP commander.
Nobody says because there are incidents in Madrid or London or Europe where terrorists execute a terrorist act that somehow the governments there or the forces have lost control of security. I mean, the reality is there are still people out there seeking to undermine the democracy and stability in this country. So it would be unrealistic to think that just because our district has transitioned that it will be incident-free. The key point to bear in mind is all we're saying is it's the Afghan forces themselves that will deal with these incidents. And I think we've seen in places like Kabul and Lashkargah, Herat and other provinces and districts which have transitioned, the Afghans are taking responsibility. That doesn't mean to say that there will be no incidents. We've always said this is a process, not an event, and the process is a transition process started a year ago, or almost a year ago, right up to 2014, when we've said that combat troops will be out of Afghanistan and the Afghan National Security Forces will have responsibility for security in the whole country. So it's a process that has started. Obviously, in the course of the next few years, troop numbers will reduce as the Afghans take on more and more responsibility. But this is the beginning of a process.